to my channel. Tonight's video is the next installment of wardrobe building, and tonight we're going to talk about dresses. So if you're interested in knowing what that is all about, just keep watching. Okay guys, so what I have done is I've brought out of my closet a few dresses that I think probably should be a basics in everyone's wardrobe. I didn't really bring out any true hardcore trends because we're going to get into that later in another episode. So this is just about some neutrals and some basics and some really comfortable silhouettes that I think flatter every plus size woman. So I tried to make them universally flattered, whether you were top heavy, bottom heavy, or whichever. I think that these would probably fit most, if not all. Okay, so we're just going to jump right in. All right, so one of the silhouettes that I love is the shirt dress, okay? So this is in navy blue. I picked the navy blue color simply because it is a neutral for me. I use navy blue when I don't wanna be in all black in the summer and the springtime. So, I mean, because you know, most of my wardrobe, like I told you guys, is basically black and mostly neutrals. But I do use navy blue as a neutral. It looks really good paired against white or yellow or pink. I mean, it works with most colors. And so I think that is a really great color to have. I picked it up in a shirt dress. This is a shirt dress that I've had for a long time. And I am trying this stuff on for you guys, so you'll be able to see me in it. And it should be right here. Or right there, I'm not sure. One of these sides you'll see it on. But this right here is just a basic cotton woven shirt dress. This one is from Gap. They have them every year. I refresh them pretty much every other year, or if I have to change sizes. I actually still fit into this one. This one is an extra large, and this is the one that I had last year. It's not as long as it used to be, but it still fits. And I think by the time I'm getting ready to grab for it, you know, I'll be fine. But I think this is a really great silhouette. You can dress this up, you can dress this down. I mean, I wear it with booties, I wear it with flats, I'll wear it with a kitten heel, I wear it with tons of accessories. The fact that it's really basic and plain means that you can take it in a whole bunch of different directions. And that is what I usually pick when I'm picking basic dresses. I like for them to be as simple as possible, the simplest silhouettes. That way that I can make it become whatever it is I want it to become. So if I need to repeat it a couple different times in my wardrobe within a week, people don't really notice it that much because I've made it look different with accessories, okay? So the next one, I know you guys know that I'm going to name, and I'm making a mess here, the little black dress, all right? So this is actually a long black dress, and this is a knit one that actually came from Lane Bryant. And it's kind of a recent purchase. I think I got it off of the clearance maybe about a month ago. So it's the double V's, one in the front, one in the back. It's the waffle knit, and it's fallen off and it's wrinkly because I tried it on for you guys, but you'll see how it looks because it's not gonna stay on. You'll see how it looks when I try it on. But these are great. What I like sleeves because I don't show my arms because of the discoloration. And that way I can just push them up. And I like dresses that give me that options of having sleeves. Now, I will wear sleeveless, like I said, but you'll usually see me with a shawl or a cardigan or something like that over it. I just like the option of being able to pull the sleeves up. Now, this one is a long maxi one, and it actually slims you. A lot of times I will put a duster over it, or I'll take a white shirt and I'll tie it. It just depends on, you know, what I'm looking for. And again, this is something that, you know, can give me a little bit of edge if I put the right shoe with it. Like, I don't know if you guys watch my other videos, and I had the Coach unboxing with the leather espadrille. I think that would look fabulous with it. Or, you know, a punk ankle boot, or, you know, any kind, if I want to do sport looks, I could do a trainer with it, you know, any kind of like sparkly bright trainer I could do with it. So I could take this simple dress and change jewelry or shoes or handbag or whatever, and I could get a million different looks out of it just by layering, you know what I mean, doing different things, adding jewelry, pendants, and all that. So that one dress, I could probably get two or three different outfits out of it in a work week if I needed to, all right? And then the next one I showed you guys is this white one, and this is part of the fit and flare trend, where it kind of goes in a little bit at the waist and then it flares back out. Of course, this one has pockets. This one is also from the Gap. This is in an extra large, and this is white. I just think a simple white dress can just really be a great addition to your wardrobe. I actually have a couple different white dresses, but I chose the fit and flare just so that you guys could see the style that I was talking about, how it goes in at the waist. Sometimes I extenuate the waist with the belt. Sometimes I don't. It just depends. A lot of times when I'm doing the fit and flare, like I said, when it's sleeveless like this, you'll probably see me with the jacket on. And because I'm in Michigan and it doesn't get extremely hot until probably like July, like right now I could do this with a motorcycle jacket and boots, or you know, I could do it with ballerina flats and a cardigan. It just depends. Now, when I'm wearing these, what I call sweet dresses, little sweetheart dresses, I usually try to make them as edgy as possible because that is just the style that I like. So you'll see me mix it with leather a lot. You'll see me take anything soft and try to rough it up a little bit, but that's just kind of like the balance that I like. I challenge you to go through your wardrobe, and you don't necessarily have to go buy a new dress. Look at some of the dresses that you have that are in the solid colors and play around with different accessories and different pieces of jewelry and different handbags and different shoes. And if you've always wore it with a heel, try it with a flat. If you've always wore it, you know, with a sandal, try it with a trainer. And you might be surprised at different looks that you can get from it just by it being a basic piece, like a basic color. When you're building these basic wardrobes, like I said, try to stick to solids just while you're doing the basic part of it. And like I said, we'll get into trends later, but as long as you're building it around solids and simple silhouettes that are classic, that won't go out of style, your wardrobe will last an extremely long time, and you will find yourself not having to update quite as much, unless of course you gain weight like me. But if you don't, if you're someone who doesn't fluctuate and you're able to maintain your sizes, those kind of styles will always be in. You'll always be able to wear a shirt dress. You'll always be able to wear a straight knit fitted dress. And you'll always be able to wear fit and flare. Those styles will always be in. Those are classic styles, always in. If you get classic colors, then that keeps you from having to update anything except for your accessories. That is everything that I have for you guys today. I appreciate you guys taking the time to watch my videos. I know we have quite a few new subscribers, and I appreciate you guys. I hope you guys found this helpful. This was the next installment in wardrobe building, and I wanted to go over, like I said, a little bit of basic dresses. And the next installment, we'll get a little bit more into some trends. We'll start visiting some trends and things like that, because I've got some really cool trends that I am noticing, and I want to bring that, you know, to the forefront so that we all know what's going on with it. There's some new cool shapes out in some pants, and then there are some colorways that I would really like to share with you guys. So, again, thanks so much for watching, and I'll holler at y'all later. Peace.